Hi dear student friends, how are you? No time, there is no time to spend it. Time is very precious. Let's we move towards the poem Once Upon a Time, written by Gabriel O'Connor. This poem is very interesting to know the difference between artificiality and naturality. Once Upon a Time is a poem written by Gabriel O'Connor. The poem is written about a father's teaching to his son regarding the dangers of fake friends and how times have changed. In this poem, the Nigerian poet O'Connor seems to be shocked by the change of lifestyle, values, morals, and the total change in the worldview in the new independent country. He seems to be mourning for the passing away of a way of life. Though the country is politically independent, it seems to be still influenced by the British culture or the Western culture. The poet remembers the way people used to behave and interact with each other, how the people used to do things with their hearts and soul. The poem, Once Upon a Time, describes the traditional African culture in the past and the influence of the Western culture over the same Africans in the present. Indeed, the poet recalls the golden times of the past. The purpose of the poem is to show the behavior and personality of the people at the moment. The poem is a conversation between a father and his son. The son does things with emotions, and father wants to forget his fake personality and relearn and recreate his personality by following the values of the past. He asks his son to express a true love and to have real concern for others. In this poem, real concern for others. In this poem, the poet has focused his attention about the artificial relationship and manners prevailing in the present world. According to him, past is better than present because there was love, sincerity, and faithfulness in the past. Now the present, in the modern society or in the modern world, everything has changed, and the finer emotions like love, affection, kindness, etc. are replaced by hypocrisy and selfishness. All kinds of relationships and friendships are only for personal benefits. Once upon a time, the people used to laugh with their hearts and eyes. That means there was genuineness and sincerity in their laugh and in their talks. But in the present days, there is only outward teeth laugh without understanding the speaker's real self. In this poem, the eyes are described as ice block cold. The people in the modern world have become money-minded, and they develop their relationships only with the rich. Even when shaking hands with others, they are very artificial and mechanical. In this materialistic and artificial world, the poet has learnt many things, especially wearing the different faces like home face, office face, cocktail face, and so on. As this is the way of the world, the poet has also learnt to laugh with the teeth, the art of saying goodbye when he means good riddance, glad to meet you when he is not glad at all, and nice talking to you when bored. The poet wants his son to imbibe the values of the past and appeals him to smile wholeheartedly. Thus, the poet has realized that the early values which always existed in the African society, like sincerity, good neutralness, naturedness, simplicity, wholeheartedness, hospitality, friendliness, originality, identity, uniqueness and overall satisfaction have now faced a drastic and dramatic change. Therefore, the poet wants his son to imbibe the values of the past and appeal him to smile wholeheartedly, and he himself wants to get back his lost identity in the world of naturality. However, all through this poem, the father has advised his son to involve himself, to act upon the scope or the limitations of the naturality but not the artificiality, because artificiality is always temporary, but only the naturality is always or totally it is the eternal values. Thank you.